Hi, and welcome to this video for Math Resource Studio 6. And as you can see here, I'm using the Professional Edition. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to add an addition word problem. And these are under basic number operations, and there's four of them: addition, division, multiplication, subtraction, and they all work similarly, but I'm just going to work with addition today, just so you can, just as a quick demonstration. So by default, we do have some questions that will show up when you first bring the program up, but I want to add my own, so I'm going to come over here to the options pane, select edit problem templates. And when the ellipsis button shows up here, I'm going to click the ellipsis button, and the problem editor will show up. So you can see here that there are some problems added already. I have active unchecked because I want to be able to see the new ones that I've added fairly easily. And so I'm ready to start adding my first template here. I can type in here, or I can paste text in that I've copied from some other source. So I'm just going to do that. I'm going to paste in some text that I already have worked with. And this just makes it a little easier to quickly create a problem template. And these are my tags. So what I need to do is replace the add-ins, the objects like apples, the names, whatever, into tags, so that when the template is added, then each time you click generate, you're going to get a slightly different variation of that problem. So let's start with the names here. So we have the first name is Douglas. Douglas, Douglas, Douglas. Okay, so we want to replace his name with name male number one, okay, because he's the first person in this, Annie, so Douglas. So I'll just double click here, and now you can type these tags in as well. It just depends on whether you prefer typing or I think probably using the tags themselves, these tag buttons are just a little more accurate. Now I'm working on the second name of Annie, and she's female, and she's the second one. So we've got our first person, now we need our second person. So I'm going to use female, name female, okay. And I could adjust this, I could make it more generic, I could make it two males or two females, but it just, when you're looking at the sentence, you see there's references made to him or her or whatever, so it's just easier for me to replace the sentence specific things in the problem with exactly the same kinds of general tags. Okay, so we've got the names. Now let's deal with the objects here. So we're adding apples to apples. Okay. So a classic, and I don't want to lose my punctuation here, so I'll just let's put an extra space in there. That's fine. Another apple, and let's put that in and take up that space. Another apples. That one's all right. And another apples. That spacing's fine. Okay, so we have the names, we have the objects, the apples. Okay, and now we're going to deal with the numbers. So in this case, this is basically A plus B equals your answer. And so it's add in number one. So we're going to replace that number with add in number one. And this is your add in number two. There we go. And you can see one of the samples down here actually starts out with a sum. And if I wanted to take a look at what kind of problem this creates, I can just press the check button here, and I can see a preview of what this template will do. So in this case, it's 16 balls were in a basket, 4 are red and the rest are green. How many balls are green? Now this is actually more of a subtraction question, but it's a kind of an interesting way to reinforce addition is by starting with the sum and working backwards. So it's like if you put 16 equals a plus 4 or something like that. So you can set up these addition questions either way. And this one here is your basic, you know, add something to add something and you get an answer. Okay, so I think we have all of our tags in here correctly. So what I'm going to do before I add it to the grid down here is I'm going to check it, take a look at the preview. And it says, Adam has 6 apples. Great. Jennifer has 5 apples. If Jennifer gives all of her apples to Adam, how many apples will Adam have? So all of my replacements are correct. Sentence looks correct. There's no extra spaces. The tags are working correctly. And let's check the math. 6 plus 5 equals 11. So that looks like it's pretty good. I can check it just one more time just to make sure that there's nothing odd that I'm not sure about. And these, the names and the objects and the add-ins are being picked up by whatever options are set up, are selected in the options pane here. So that's where it's getting those all these different things from. But I think we're looking good. So I click OK, and now I'm going to add this down below. Okay, so now I've just got 2 of them checked that are active. I'm going to uncheck this one just so the only one we see when it adds questions is the one I've just lately added. And I'm going to click Save and then OK. And now here's our questions. So as you can see, we've got our question template creating the kinds of questions I expected. So there we go. That's just a quick review of how to add an addition problem template to the word problems for addition. And like I say, it works similarly in division, multiplication, and subtraction. It's the same kind of setup. And thank you for looking at this video. For more information, you can take a look at the help documentation in the program, which is under info here. Or you can always contact us at support@schoolhousetechnologies. Thanks very much.